Hey everyone, Knowledge here with Reach Your Summit. Thanks for joining me. This video is going to be another installment in the Ultra Lone Peak series. Yeah, that's right. We are going to be going over the brand new Lone Peak 5 shoes. Those of you that are familiar with this channel know that I've been wearing the Lone Peaks exclusively for the last couple of years on backpacking trips, hiking, and everything else. I started with the 4.0s, really enjoyed them. They had a couple of minor setbacks, and when the 4.5s came out, I was really excited for those, but it took away from some of the things I really enjoyed about the 4.0s. So I'm really excited to go over this shoe. I'm looking forward to putting a lot of mileage in it. This video is going to be more of a first look. I have very limited mileage in the shoe at the moment, but there are a lot of upgrades from the 4.5s that I want to share with you all, and I'm really excited with these upgrades. So with this video, we'll go over this shoe. I'll compare it to the 4.5, and I know some of you might be saying, but wait a minute, didn't he have the lime green shoe on this channel for the 4.5 video? Yes, those shoes are still kicking. The tread is completely worn down though, so I don't wear them backpacking or hiking as much. I mainly use them now for landscaping, working on my car, and walking around town. So once those had worn out, I picked up a solid black pair and been using those until we transitioned to winter time. And then I went back to the 4.0 mid RSMs. And then the 5s came out. So we'll go over this shoe and I'll give you a comparison between this and the 4.5. So let's start with a couple of increases with the Lone Peak 5. The first is the cost. The 4.5s and the 4.0s had cost $120. The price has jumped up to $130. So there is that $10 difference. Another increase with this shoe is the overall weight. So on my scale with the 4.5, I think they came in, if I remember correctly, around 21 ounces for the pair. I'll put a link in the description for this video for the 4.5 video and the 4.0 if you want to check those out. The 5s have increased in weight to 11.1 ounces per shoe, bringing it to a total of 22.2 ounces. Still a very lightweight and extremely comfortable shoe. That weight increase is mostly due to the midsole changing. They are now using the Ultra Ego foam that you'll find in shoes like the Escalante. This is one upgrade that I really have been appreciating so far. It gives me that similar soft cushion that I really enjoyed with the 4.0s. I found the 4.5s to be a little stiffer underfoot. I like having the softer cushion underfoot with the Lone Peak shoes. The shoe is also using a updated stone guard, which has given me really good protection underfoot with rocks and roots that I have used it in, mainly because it is still winter time here. Most of the terrain that I had used this shoe in so far has been ice and snow with a good pair of waterproof socks. Couple of things that have not changed. The shoe is still using the MaxTrack tread on the bottom and also the trail claw system, which also gives me really good grip and a really good natural feel and contour on the ground when I'm stepping on it with this shoe. One thing that I have noticed with this shoe is the fit. So I wore a 10.5 for the 4.5s and the 4.0. I'm still wearing the 10.5 with the 5, but I did find the shoe to be a little narrower than the 4.5s. That may or may not be a deal breaker for you. One added benefit to the 5s is that Ultra now offers this shoe in a wide. So if you found the Lone Peaks to be too tight around your foot in the past, definitely consider checking that out as an option. It is going to be a lot wider. It was too wide for me. My foot was swimming around inside of it, so I stuck with the average width. With the change in the midsole using the Ultra Ego, the terminology has changed, and you won't see this being listed as having zero drop, although it does. The zero drop is now being called balanced cushioning, which is still keeping your heel and your forefoot at the same positioning from the ground. The stack height has also not changed. It is 25 millimeters. A couple of great upgrades to this shoe. First, the toe cap. I did have some issues with my 4.0s peeling, and I just used some super glue and I didn't have any major problems after that. And with the 4.5s, I honestly didn't have any issue with it. But Ultra has addressed the toe cap, and they have sewn in the toe cap along with the glue. So that reinforcement will give it more durability and less likelihood to run into that problem. This was an upgrade that I was really happy to see, and I look forward to putting it to the test and seeing how it holds up over time. Another upgrade to the shoe are the drainage ports in the front. There are a lot more drainage ports in this shoe, and this is going to increase the quick drying time that I've experienced with the past iterations, but it's also going to allow any water that might get into the shoe, it's going to displace it out a lot quicker. The entire upper has been upgraded also. So the upper on the 4.5s to me felt a little more softer. The upper on this feels a little more rigid, a little more robust, and a little more durable. The durability definitely looks to be there with this shoe. The whole inner lining has also been changed. It feels less meshy feeling like the 4.5s had. I find this to be a little softer, a little more comfortable overall. The other part of the upper that has been updated, which I was happy to see, is the tongue of the shoe. So with the 4.5s, had this strap right along the tongue to allow the lacing to get woven through it and keep the tongue a little more secure. And that has been reduced on this, which I feel helps increase the overall volume of the shoe. The loops on the back of the heel have also been reduced. With the 4.5s, you had two of them. It has been brought back to just a single loop. The shoe does still have the gaiter trap and the gaiter hook on the front. So I'm happy to still see the gaiter trap and the hook on this one, just because I do like using gaiters when I'm out using these backpacking and hiking. This shoe does also come in a bunch of great colors, red. There's also a lime green similar to the 4.5s, black. I had to go with the blue with the green. Blue is just one of my colors, so I was happy to see that being offered with this shoe. Overall, I'm really happy with the upgrades that this shoe has and the overall feel of the shoe. It's very responsive on the trips that I've used it on so far, and I'm really looking forward to bringing this out a lot more in three-season conditions once all of the snow and ice starts melting and I can really put some distance on these shoes. Have any of you used the Lone Peak 5s yet? If you have, please leave your feedback in a comment below. I'd love to hear it. I hope you all found this video helpful. If you have any questions on this shoe or anything else in my other videos, feel free to get in touch in a comment below, or you can contact me at reachyoursummit.net. If you like this video, hit the like button and consider subscribing and hit that notification bell, as I'm always adding new content to this channel. I look forward to sharing an update with all of you as I get a lot more mileage in with this shoe. As always, thank you for watching, and until the next one, I'll see you on the trail.